look, let's stay in the US because Trump's VP pick has mocked Kamala Harris in front of Air Force Two for failing to give an interview since becoming the Democratic Party presidential nominee. This is what he said.
I just wanted to check out my future plane, but I also wanted to go say hello to the vice president and ask her why Kamala Harris refuses. Why does she refuse to answer questions from the media? And I also thought that the press gaggle following her might get a little lonely. I at least have enough respect for you all and for the American people you report to come and talk to you.
Mark, this guy's hilarious. He certainly isn't shy, but he raises a good point. Why will she not come out and say some words, speak, do something? What do you think?
100%. Yes, 17 days that she's hidden away. She's reading off a teleprompter. Unfortunately, though, and I hope this message starts resonating with people, this is they're kind of winning at this point. There's so much momentum behind Harris that she's getting up there. She's reading off the teleprompter. They're not missing a beat. I want to see more of this sort of spunk from JD. We need to move away from the whole couch thing that he's getting aligned with all the time. And he needs to just get out there, ruffle a few feathers. You know, be a bit more Trumpian about it. I just can't believe that we've already moved on from the fact that the former president got shot at, and we're already moving on to watching Harris fire up the crowds and all that sort of stuff. It's pretty scary what's going on in the States, but hopefully they can turn around. I just want to see a bit more spunk from the boys.
Absolutely. That's a fair point. Absolutely. You're right. It's moved on so quick. Yeah, Hannah, so I mean, maybe Kamala Harris can't speak without a teleprompter like her predecessor. I mean, maybe this is why she's not doing interviews. Maybe it's the curse of the Democrats. I don't know, but I think it's strange. Do you think it's strange?
Yeah. I think she's in real trouble. I mean, this is their worst nightmare. A couple of blokes they're up against who can, walk up to a press group with swagger and talk off the cuff and, think on their feet. This is, that's playing dirty as far as the Democrats are concerned. They're completely out of their depth unless they're sitting in front of a teleprompter and, rattling off rehearsed lines. We've seen time and time again what happens when Kamala Harris is put on the spot, and she usually just sort of goes into cackle mode, and it's a disaster. So I think JD Vance has shown that he's he does have that swagger, he does have that spunk, and he's got an ability to engineer a situation to his own advantage in much the same way that Donald Trump's always been able to do. So I mean, just look at the assassination attempt. Who else could have turned an assassination attempt into a sort of media triumph the way he did? There's a bit of that going on, I think.
Only Trump could do something like that, and he did it quite well, I've got to say.